Microsoft certifications are a way to prove to everyone, specifically the employers, that you actually have learned and have the skills required to master one of the Microsoft certifications. By having any one of these certifications, you are gaining an edge over all the competitors that you have. In this video, I'm going to show you how to claim a 100% free voucher for Microsoft certification exams at the fundamental levels. All you need to have is a Microsoft account and your student email address. It can be your email from your college or university. You have to be an active student or a newly graduate. I'm going to show you all the steps required to register, learn, practice, and register for the certification of Microsoft. There are a few steps involved. There are a few different sites that you need to visit. I recommend watching the video completely first and then follow along on the second time. Keep in mind, the username and password that you select, the email address that you select would be the email address that you are going to create a profile on Pearson VUE and Microsoft Learn website. Before we start, if you don't already have a Microsoft account, put this video on pause and watch the video to learn how to create a Microsoft account for free, and then come back when you have your Microsoft account ready. Let's start. Start by going to Microsoft Student Hub certification webpage. Go to aka.ms/student-certification-webpage. You can find all the links in the description as well. This will take you to the student certification section of the Microsoft Learn webpage. Microsoft Learn is the new home to all of the Microsoft training materials and certifications. Even after you get certified, Microsoft Learn is the place where you can see all your certifications and badges. I will review this page later in this video. Once you're on the page, select Sign In on the top right corner of the screen to log in. You need to use a Microsoft account. Please note, this would be the account that will represent you and will contain all your certifications, badges, and training points. Changing this email in the future is not very easy. I've seen students who use their college or university email addresses, and after their graduation, when the university closes their mailboxes, they faced issues with their portal access as well. I personally recommend that if you don't already have a Microsoft account, it would be best to create one for this purpose and use that. Microsoft accounts are free. If you need to learn how to create a Microsoft account, put this video on pause and click on the link on top of your screen to watch that video before you continue. If this is the first time you are signing into Microsoft Learn website, Microsoft will prompt you to confirm if you're using the correct account. System will ask, before registering with this Microsoft account, please check if you may have previously registered with a different account. Double check your account and click Next to start creating your Microsoft Learn profile. On the first page, start by typing your name for the profile. This is the name that would be visible on your profile achievement page. Confirm your name's spelling and hit Next. You can change this name in the settings later if you would like. Next page is where you can confirm the email address and country and also identify if you would like to receive updates from Microsoft. This page is optional, and if you want, you can skip it. Make your selection and click Save. This will complete the process for creating your Microsoft Learn profile. Click OK to view your profile. This page has a few different sections. On the top, you can see your display name and email address. You can also see a level and XP or experience points. Microsoft has added a little gamifications to the Learn as well. For every module you learn, you will get some points, and by collecting more points, you will be moving to higher levels. Then you can see your dashboard. Badges will show the number of badges you've earned during your study. Every exam or certification you get has at least one badge. Trophies are similar too. Microsoft will give you different trophies based on achieving different milestones, like completing an online training module. Reputation points means how reputable is this account, but how do we become more reputable? There are different methods. You can write articles, post answers to questions, and many more ways. Accepted answers show how many of your answers to the questions have been marked as correct and accepted by the person posting the question. Finally, similar to most social networks, you can follow other educators or allow other educators to follow you. Following and followers show the number of people you are following and the number of people that are following you. If you click on your profile picture and select Settings, you can configure all the available settings related to your profile. You can see your profile URL, display name, and many more settings. Looking at the left menu in the setting show you all the different sections of the settings which you can modify to meet your requirements. Now that you have created your Microsoft Learn profile, you are ready to continue your journey toward a free certification. Now that you are logged in, go back to Microsoft Learn homepage and go to the training page from the top menu. From the training page, scroll all the way down to the end of the page and under Resources, select Student Resources. This will take you to the Student Hub portal section of the website. Microsoft Learn website is a huge website with too many sections, pages, and subpages. Please double check the address before making your selections. In this page, you can find lots of useful and free training material. For certifications, please scroll down until you see more free resources. From there, select Student Certifications. Now, you should be signed in to the Student Certification section of Microsoft Learn website. Scroll to the end of the page. Here you need to verify and confirm that you are a student. Click on Verify Your Student Status. This will take you to the Cloud Ready Skills website. From the top right, click Sign In. On the next page, the website will ask you for permission to read your profile. Click Yes. You are now signed in to Cloud Ready Skills and need to type in your college or university name and select your country. If you are a student, confirm your status by selecting I confirm that I am a student. Also, accept the consent to receive emails and click Submit. System will take you back to the main page and asks you to verify your student status. Click on Verify Your Student Status. System will take you to verify.microsoft.com webpage. Select I have a school email account and type your student email address on both boxes and click Verify. System will send you an email to confirm that you are a student and have access to your student mailbox. Sometimes it might take a few hours before you receive the email, and there are times that the email might land in your junk folder or spam folder. Make sure to check all the folders in your mailbox. After you receive the email, either click on the link or copy the link and paste it in the same browser. Right-click on the link and select Copy Hyperlink. Open a new tab and paste the link. Now you should see Congratulations page, and your academic status should have been successfully verified. Click Continue. This will close the verification page and take you to the Microsoft homepage. Close Microsoft homepage and go back to Cloud Ready Skills website. If you have closed the page, you can find the link in the description as well. As you can see in this page, system shows that you are identified, and if you would like, you can verify your status. By completing these steps, you notice that you can now access all the fundamental level certifications and start your training journey. In order to get a free exam voucher, you need to start your learning journey, complete the training, and do some sample tests. Select your desired certification and hit Start Journey. All the fundamental level exams come with a badge with 1 star. This is the badge that you can use in your social networks such as LinkedIn. This is a proof that you have successfully passed the exam and earned the certificate. There are 3 steps to get the free exam voucher. Learn the subjects and topics, prepare for the exam by reviewing some questions and answers, and finally get the voucher. Once you have the voucher, you will then need to register for the exam. As you can notice, the prepare and certify are locked at the beginning. They would be automatically unlocked as you move along with the learning steps. To start, click Explore under Learn. System will take you back to the Microsoft Learn page for the selected certificate. In this example, I can see there are 2 modules and I can see the approximate time needed for reviewing each module. Select your first module to start your learning. The training is very interactive and self-guided. By reading each section and clicking Next, you will see you get some XP points, and then you move forward. In some pages, you might have interactive slides, videos, or activities that you will need to complete. At the end of each module, there is a knowledge check test, usually 3 to 4 questions about the content of that module. Once you answer the questions, you can check your results by hitting Check Answers and even review your responses before moving to the next module. After completing each module, you can unlock your achievement and move on to the next module. Continue to the end of all modules to complete your training. I do recommend reading them as they have a lot of good and well-designed content. Alternatively, if you have studied the material in other methods and would like to skip this part, you can provide your consent that you have completed the learning material and are ready to review the practice test. Go back to your Cloud Ready Skills website, click the self-attestation toggle, and confirm. You will notice that Prepare section is now unlocked and you can start the sample tests. Click on Practice Test. System will open a new tab and take you to Microsoft Learn page where you have access to many sample questions and answers. As you see, there is a fair amount of questions, answers, and description for each question. Now that you have reviewed the practice test, you are ready to claim your voucher. Click on Claim. System confirms the action by showing a message that reads, "You can now claim your 100% discount exam voucher for your selected exam." Confirm the action by clicking Claim. You now have a voucher for 100% discount for the specific exam you selected. You can use this voucher on Pearson VUE Exam Center. Copy the code and save it in a notepad. You can also notice that there is a link with information about how to register for Pearson VUE Exam Center and how to redeem your voucher and other link with information about accommodations. You can now log into your Pearson VUE portal and book your exam online. On the next section of this video, I'm going to show you how to register for Pearson VUE Exam Center and how to book your appointment and schedule an exam online. If you are prepared and ready for the exam, click on Book Your Exam. This will take you to Microsoft Learn website for your selected exam. You can see the general information about the course and the exam price. You can ignore the price for now. Scroll down and click on Schedule with Pearson VUE. First, system will take you to the exam registration page of Microsoft where you need to provide your information, including your name, address, and phone number. This is the name that should match your legal or government-issued documents when writing the exam. Whether you go to the test center or do the exam at home with online monitoring, you are required to provide a proof of identity that matches your information provided in this page. You need to prove your identity before you can start the exam. You will need to provide a government-issued document such as passport or driving license. Fill the information and click Save and Continue. System will tell you to confirm that the provided information will match a government-issued identification that you will present at your exam appointment. Click Accept and then click Continue. On the next page, click Schedule Exam. System will transfer you to Pearson VUE website. Now you have two options. You can either schedule your exam at a test center near you, or you can schedule to write the exam online at home. Please keep in mind that if you do the exam online, you have to make sure that you have access to a reliable internet, a reliable computer with camera and a working microphone. A Pearson VUE agent would be watching you and recording your webcam and microphone feed for the duration of the exam, and your computer would be locked. No one else is allowed to be in the same room as you are writing the exam, and no other computer or cell phone or tablet should be in your reaching distance. If you have multiple monitors, you have to disconnect them, and you are only allowed to work with single monitor. I would recommend reading the details, rules, and regulations about online exams at Pearson VUE website. To schedule your exam at a test center, select At a Test Center and click Next. Select your preferred language for the exam and click Next. Confirm you have read the agreement and non-disclosure, then click Next. On the next page, review the terms and conditions and click Agree to continue. On the next page, depending on your address, system will show you the closest test centers. Select one center based on your location and click Next. On the next page, system will show you the available dates for the center that you can book. Select your preferred date, and system will show you available time slots. If you would like, you can click on Explore More Times to see if there are other times available. Select your desired date and time slot and click Book the appointment. If you would like to do the exam at home, select Online at my home or office and then click Next. Select your preferred language for the exam and click Next. Confirm that you have read the agreement and non-disclosure, then click Next. On the next page, review the terms and conditions and click Agree to continue. you will notice there are few more checkboxes related to online exam regulations that you need to review and accept by clicking Agree. On the next page, you can select the language of the proctor. As mentioned earlier, for online exams, a proctor would be monitoring your webcam and microphone feed for the duration of the exam. In this page, you can select the language of the proctor. On the next page, you will have to confirm your time zone. After confirming your time zone, select the date for your exam, and based on the date, you can select the available time slots. After you made your selection, click on Book This Appointment. System will add the exam to your cart. And yes, you can ignore the price because we do have a voucher. You can see the system will prompt you to buy some extra practice tests as well. If you need, you can add them to your cart, but it would not be covered by your voucher. Your voucher covers only the cost of the exam. Make your selection and then click Proceed to checkout. On the checkout page, select Add Voucher or Promo Code. On the open box, type in the code that we received from the voucher. Please note, this code is assigned to you and cannot be transferred to others. After you apply the code, you can see the price goes down to $0 and no more credit card information is needed. Click Next, review the information, and submit order. Congratulations, you have now registered for your Microsoft certification exam. One last step as an optional action. Optionally, you can connect your certification profile to your Microsoft Learn profile. If you log in back to your Microsoft Learn, you can see a message prompting you to connect your certification profile to your Microsoft Learn profile. Simply click Connect Certification Profile to proceed. System will show you your email and MCID, and you can complete the connection by simply clicking Yes, Connect the Certification Profile. After this connection, all your certificates would be presented in your Microsoft Learn profile as well.
Congratulations! If you're still watching, that means that you are creating your account and you are registering for one of the exams. Please leave a comment in the comment section down below if you found this video helpful and which Microsoft certification did you go for, and let me know if you got certified. See you on the next video.